The Great Salt Lake in Utah evaporating before our eyes. Scientists say it may disappear altogether in 5 years, but could be saved with some emergency measures. Many experts believe what's happening there is a microcosm of what's expected to happen to the planet. So let's check in now with our chief climate correspondent, Mr. Bill Weir, live in St. George, Utah. Bill, what's going on here?
Well, Don, here in Utah, this mega drought is not just about the water they drink or use to water their crops and animals. It is about the air they breathe. It is about toxic dust. And they're realizing now that if they don't spend billions to put more water into the Great Salt Lake, they could be paying much more forever.
This is what is left of the Great Salt Lake. It hit record lows in recent months, exposing around 800 square miles of lake bed. But unchecked water use and climate change aren't just threatening the birds and sailboaters. And here, the Western mega drought threatens a lot more than just snow sports, agriculture, and industry.
Because this lake bed holds centuries of toxic runoff: mercury, selenium, arsenic, some of it natural, some of it man-made mining waste. But if it turns to dust and adds to some of the worst air pollution in the country, this is a threat to the lungs of over 2.5 million people.
We've done this experiment in history before. We know about dust storms. We know about particulate pollution. We know about heavy metals and how they're bad for humans. This is an ecological disaster that will become a human health disaster.
Bonnie Baxter is among the scientists who recently warned that the Great Salt Lake, as we know it, could be gone in 5 years. Shriveled into fingers of lifeless water before becoming the great toxic dust bowl.
You can kind of see a person standing out there like the water would have been above their head just a few years ago.
This is what is known as a terminal lake with no rivers to take minerals to the sea. So they build up over time, just like Owens Lake in California, after developers notoriously drained it a century ago to build Los Angeles. It both inspired the movie Chinatown and forced Californians to spend in the billions to control the toxic dust that remains a threat 100 years later.
This lake is 12 to 15 times bigger than Owens Lake. It's right next to a metropolitan center, which that lake was not. So there are people who will breathe this dust immediately. And we're really, really concerned about that happening here. So we have done that experiment. We shouldn't do it again.
It was human choices that led to that catastrophic event. Right, we're looking at the Great Salt Lake in a position right now to where we can avoid that catastrophe, where we don't have to spend those billions of dollars in remediation in the future if we make choices today.
Brian Steed and John Lynn are from rival Utah universities, one with a background in state government, the other an atmospheric scientist.
Well, the thing is, it's bipartisan, right? The air quality, we all want clean air.
Together, they're part of the newly formed Great Salt Lake Strike Team, out to convince everyone that every drop counts.
For a long time, I don't think that people were sufficiently talking for the lake. Now I think that we have a lot of people interested, the governor of the state, the legislature, who's all very interested in coming up with different scenarios and different solutions so that we don't end up with that catastrophic outcome.
It seems like the path of least resistance is for the state to pay farmers for their water rights. Is that going to happen?
I don't know. It remains to be seen. I mean, I think there's a lot of things that we could do that go to that extreme.
Among the signs of change, when U.S. Magnesium wanted to extend canals into the lake, the state said no. And last year, the legislature finally began revising water laws written in the days of the Wild West.
Sometimes I feel like we take a step forward and sometimes we take a step back, but in general, all those pieces of water legislation that passed in 2022 were bipartisan and unanimous. Like, where does that happen anymore?
Fingers crossed it keeps happening, because the only thing that can keep the Salt Lake great is lots of snow and even more cooperation.
About two-thirds of Utah's population is at risk of this dust right now, but they're finally coming around to this. They're finally getting water meters in the year 2023 to really measure exactly how much the farmers are using, and they hope knowledge is power to keep that lake alive. Don, Poppy?
We hope so. Thank you, Bill Weir. Appreciate that.